This one's really interesting, and I can see how it's very confusing, and it's not just confusing for new coders, but it gets confusing for experienced coders too. The verbiage, the terminology kind of overlaps. Like, oh, what do I need to do? So the question was, if a chart has documented at the patient that the patient has a substernal chest pain radiating to the left shoulder, and when pain is at its worst, feels pressure, should she code 786.51 or 786.51 and 786.59? Okay, and she wants to know, can you code two codes in the same category? Let's go look and see what we've got here. So 786.51 is chest pain or precordial. Is that how do you say that, Lorraine? I know
yeah.
We say things
differently.
Precordial
yep.
pain. So in plain English, what does that mean? Now this is really important because if you don't know what precordial pain is, you're up a creek. So that's where the definitions and anatomy and physiology really plays a part in the coding. So you use this code to report precordial pain or chest pain over the heart at the bottom of the chest below the left nipple. Okay, so you're think of this on a man, not a woman, because you know anatomy can be up or down on a woman. But that, so you're thinking of this in a square. So you know, kind of think, picture this as a square. So now on 786.59, chest pain other, and that's where we get into that other discomfort in the chest, pressure in the chest, tightness in the chest, and this is going to exclude pain in the breast, and they give you the code for that. So other forms of chest pain or discomfort, such as tightness of the chest. Now, the reason she's questioning this is because both apply. It's in one way or another. And she's saying, can I use both of these codes to list what's going on with the patient? My first thought was, no, you need to come up with the best definition. But what they're saying is, okay, this person has the first code. That really applies to what they're having. But if did they take a deep breath? It was something like that. Then it changed. You know, so then they got that pressure and tightness in the chest. That's actually a different description. The answer is yes, you can use both of those codes. What I think I would do in this case is I would query the physician. Go in and ask him, show him what your choices are and say, you know, I just want to make sure that I understand the documentation, which, you know, and this is real easy, you know, you can show him. Now, if he says, yeah, it's both, go ahead and code both. Now, your second thought is, okay, you know, is this going to give me any trouble on the other end? Ultimately, it falls to the payer, okay? The payer may say no. You need to give me one or the other, or the payer may say, "Yeah, that's fine. We don't care." So he documented that both of those apply. So you could use both of those codes. You can use, you know, both of those codes if in the same category if they apply. It doesn't happen very often. The payer may look at it and say, "No, you need to use one or the other," and then, you know, again, what I would do is I would say, tell the doctor, you know, okay, you know, Blue Cross Blue Shield of Texas said they want you to use one in this section, you know, which best describes in your opinion, give him your choices and he'll say, okay, take this one. You know, so that's the steps that I would take. I would say, yes, you could probably use one. There's no rules or regulations that say you can't. Your job is to code to the highest specificity of from the documentation you're given. Check with get a full description, make sure there's no other code out there that is better. You know, that maybe, you know, and there isn't, but I'm saying, what if there's a, you know, 787 or something that might fall into that? Check with other coders, see if they've had that experience, query the doctor, make sure that you understand his documentation, and then ask your payer if you think it's going to be a problem.
Get more CPC exam tips, coding certification training, and CEU credits. Go to www.codingcertification.org.